history over and over again, over and over again, over and over again. Throughout this whole dream, I'm smiling. My face really hurts, but I keep smiling. I wonder why I keep smiling. Oh, it's the faces. There are these faces that just keep staring at me. Up and down, down and up. It's like they want me to do something. But what? Oh, it's the day of my quinceañera. And all these faces are my closest 385 relatives here to see me. My hair is curled and pinned. My makeup is subtle, but beautiful. Everything's perfect. At least, it looks perfect. Until... I feel as I'm not wearing a dress. Patty, why haven't you put your dress on yet? Go put it on, we're gonna be late. I'll be right back. Okay. Hi, I'm Rebecca, Patty's dama. But more importantly, her best friend. We grew up together. We've done everything together. School, catechism, crushing over cute boys, and now quinceañeras. I'm her dama, and she'll be mine. I couldn't ask anybody else. Your dama's supposed to be your best friend. What kind of best friend would you be if you didn't ask? But we've got each other's back.
Rebecca! Help me find my dress!
Clear culo!
I mean,
be there in a second, beautiful.
Hey, I'm so sorry about that.
Yeah, I need to go.
Sure, of course. I'll see you at the, thing.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Sangbo. This is my first quinceañera. I've never been asked to be a San Bernardino before. I don't really know what I'm supposed to do. I should have looked it up or something before I said yes. But I like it so far. Maybe Rebecca will ask me to be in her quinceañera. Sangbo! What's up, man? Hunter, Hunter's wife!
Oh, man. I'm Andrew, Patty's chambelán. Yeah, I basically follow her around all day.
Make her look good.
That's what we do with these things.
Is that all that we do? Do we do anything else?
Not really. See, today is about the quinceañera. That's why it's called the quinceañera. She gets everything. The dress, the court, all the attention, all the good luck charms. We're more like good looking charms. We stand there and bam! Hey, good looking. Bam! Good looking.
So, what does Rebecca do?
Well, she acts like a good-looking charm as well, but she's much more than that. She's an extra pair of arms. Anything the quinceañera needs, Rebecca will take care of. Patty gets whatever she wants. It is the rule of the day.
Boys, Patty wants you to go help Violetti move some tables.
Okay, got it.
Patty! Come over here! Boys are gone!
Woo! Can I see yourself? Yes, it's gonna be a surprise! This better be worth it! Oh. Patty, you look so beautiful! Is this really me? Of course it is. You're the one in the poofy dress.
I look hideous!
Sable, that's a really cool tie, man.
Thanks. My mom bought it for me.
Oh. Thank you.
So, Mommy told me that in order to have this quinceañera, I needed to have a mass. People need to see that you are still religious and that you're not just doing this for the party. Of course not. I'm not just doing this for the party. Besides, you can still have one without a mass. Either way, people are still going to see what they want to see. They will see the mujercita that I have become. Though I wonder, what kind of mujercita are they seeing, you know? Like, what is she? What does she do? They probably see the one that is caring and nurturing and sings lullabies and other thoughtful songs. Ananita heya. She cannot be sexy and strut her stuff. That's too much. She maintains an adequate fear of her body, or else she'll let herself go. And if she thinks before she speaks, she's wrong. But if she speaks before she thinks,
I feel like maybe she's wrong.
A mujercita strives to be confident, strong, and bold.
Confident!
Strong!
Bold!
Pero tampoco tanto. She is allowed to doubt herself and her steps, but not too much. She loves fully and completely, no matter what. That is the mujercita that they all see. Is that the one I see?
Keep them away.
I don't know what they're after.
They want your body.
Oh, I thought they were like zombies after my brains.
Your body is sacred, and you need to protect it.
Well, I do love my body. But what makes it so sacred?
Do it or risk not being a proper young lady. You'll learn soon enough.
But what if I don't learn? What if I'm not a proper young lady?
What then?
Besides your family, traditions are all you have, and you will carry on these traditions.
Traditions feel more like rules. Rules are meant to be broken.
Juan.
Yep, he's the Juan.
Oh my God, I can't believe this. Oh my God, oh my God.
Wait, what part don't you believe? The fact that I did it? Or the fact that the hottest guy at school did it with me?
Hey, props to you. You got the hottie with the body. You know, everyone at school thinks you like Andrew.
I do.
Ah, I knew it.
But maybe not like that.
Well, why not? After middle school, he got boy.
He totally did. That's why I asked him to be my chambelán de honor. But I just don't know if I want to do that with him.
Okay, hypothetically. What if he asked you out and you guys started dating and you liked each other and the opportunity came up, if you know what I mean? Well, wouldn't you want to do it then?
Maybe? Yes? No? I just don't think I can handle any more awkward.
Well, when you're ready, I'm sure it won't be that awkward.
Yeah, when I'm ready.
Hey guys!
Are you ready to go to the party?
Yeah, we're ready.
Please bless my niece and protect her from the various temptations that will lead her astray.
Oh my God!
Guide her to your path of righteousness. Amen.
And I see Maria, my attractive cousin. And there.
¿Qué un trago?
No, 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 no,
to Quinceañera before. I bet the nachos will be really authentic. Very caliente.
Thank you.
to be here.
Then there's Brittany, our life friend. I mean, my good friend.
OMG, I didn't even know that Patty was Mexican. She doesn't have that funny accent like my gardeners do.
And then there's David, who's mom, his friend's mine.
Encima del sol, por debajo. extra sparkly.
So that thing we just did, it's pretty good, right? So, I saw your uncle earlier, staring at your aunt, holding a switchblade. It was kind of concerning.
Oh, that's just still César. Dad's out of the family. He got asked to be in a movie once.
Really?
Yeah, Mexican in the background, number 4.
It would have sounded like your uncle playing a Mexican on TV, making it seem all sketchy like.
someone who can cook and dance. And my uncle would add, if you can't dance, you'll never get laid. And of course, she has to be a Mexican.
Well, I'm Mexican. But I don't dance. But I also don't wear this all the time.
You know what? Forget that stuff. It's all superficial anyways. I mean, take Sango for example. I mean, he's not Mexican. But he can dance. But he's definitely not Mexican.
I wonder what would happen if he and Rebecca started dating. What would her parents say, you know, about her dating?
In Asian.
It's but real.
It's okay though, because he's really nice. And if you really had to, he could learn Spanish.
Totally.
You know, I have a lot of cousins. Half of them don't speak Spanish. But they're still super Mexican.
There's a lot of reasons why someone wouldn't speak Spanish. I mean, who wants to be friends with a weird Spanish speaker in the class? And teachers are always getting so angry. You know, my brother once got hit with a ruler for speaking Spanish in class? He won't respond to my parents for months.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
But just look at him now. He's at college. How is he, by the way?
He's good. He's really good. Except every time he comes home, he's always talking about revolution, brown power. Resist the man, keep your culture strong. Really heavy stuff, you know?
Should we be thinking about all that?
I mean, I feel like we have to, right?
It's It's just so draining, you know? You know, I bet Britain doesn't have to think about any of this stuff.
Come on.
I wish I could leave her.
Yeah, I wish I didn't have to think about this either. You know, I could use that time for something. I could write a book.
Or a play.
La muñeca is. You can't finish a quinceañera without it. It's the last ritual of the night.
But it's just a doll.
Just a doll? But it's not just a doll. This is your child. The last 14 years of your life are represented in this muñeca. She looks exactly like you. Does it mean that you don't care about yourself? Well, that's you.
Of course you do.
Why else would you have gone through all of this? You went through with your quinceañera. Now let's finish. Take your doll and give it away. You should give it to your cousin. You sure?
Yes, I'm sure. And besides, Sangbo's probably looking for you.
Yeah. Come find me when you're done. Dress, the court, the attention. But I don't need it. I am more than that dress. I am more than that pile of pretty and poof. I don't want to be that quinceañera. I don't want to be that mujercita. I want to be me. I don't know what that is. But I know that it's much more than that. And maybe all I need to do is embrace it. Embrace me. I need to embrace me.